Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you.
You are the potter.
Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. My name is Pius and I'm a teacher at Chania High School. And I, by the grace of God, I happen to be the chair of KSCF, Thika West Sub-County. I take this opportunity to share with you the word of God from the book of Jonah. The book of Jonah chapter 3. The book of Jonah chapter 3. The word of God had come to Jonah for Nineveh. The word had come to Jonah for Nineveh to repent, or the city will be destroyed. As you know, Nineveh was a great city. It was actually the capital city of Assyria in the years of 600 BC, thereabouts. It was the largest and the most popular city at that time. Nineveh was found in the place today, the place called Mosul in Iraq right now. The Lord gave Nineveh 40 days to repent, or they will be destroyed. They were given 40 days to repent for their wickedness, which included violence and many other evil ways. Now Jonah preached the message that God told him. In verse 2, the Bible says, "Go and preach to it the message that I will tell you." So Jonah was preaching the message God gave him, like the way God has given me a message for you this morning. And after 3 days, after Jonah had preached the message, after 3 days of fasting and repenting, God forgave the city, God relented, and God did not bring the punishment that he had said he would bring to the city. I want to encourage all of us this morning, as we continue praying and repenting, God is hearing our prayers, and I want to encourage all of us to continue repenting. Repenting means turning away from our wicked ways, turning away from sin, and turning to God. King Asa was told by God in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 15, verse 2. He was told that the Lord is with you while you are with him, that if you seek him, he will be found of you. And that if you forsake him, he will forsake you. The book of Matthew 7:7 says that you seek and you will find. So at this time you are seeking forgiveness. Seek forgiveness and you will find it. I want to encourage all of us, including myself, that we use this time to continue with deeper personal repentance. Let us use this time to ask the Holy Spirit to show us the issues, the wickednesses, the violence, the evil ways in our hearts, the things we have done that are wrong and are contrary to God's will. And as we continue with the repentance, the book of Numbers 23, verse 21 to 23 will come true. It will become our portion. That time, Balak had called Balaam to come and curse Israel. But because in verse 21, the Bible says that there was no iniquity or wickedness found in Israel, and that God was with them, then no witchcraft, no divination, no sorcery would have succeeded against Israel. So when we repent, When we clear ourselves with God, we put God on our side, and therefore the plans of the devil against us will not succeed because all the legal grounds are removed from us. I want to encourage all of us, including myself, our families, my colleague teachers, anyone who can hear this message, we continue with that deep repentance that will put God on our side. All legal grounds will be removed. All the issues we have in our lives, God is faithful. He will be on our side. He will address them. Because God addresses issues of our lives when He is on our side. He cannot address them when He is on the side of the enemy. Repentance brings God on our side against the enemy. And for sure, that will be assured victory. I want to thank you for that few minutes. I pray that God Almighty will help you to put that word into action. Spend much time repenting to clear yourself before God so that the enemy will not have any legal ground against us. The enemy will not have anything against us. And again, I repeat those words of Numbers 23, verse 21 to 23, so that there will be no iniquity, there will be no wickedness, sin in us. And so God will be with us. And so no plans of the enemy will succeed against us. No plans of the enemy will succeed against our families, against our church, against our nation, against the body of Christ, so long as God is on our side. Thank you so much. May God bless you. In Jesus' name I thank you and I bless you.
Change my heart, O God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, O God. May I be like you. Change my heart, O God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, O God.